Good evening. Welcome and thank you for joining me tonight for the 2024 State of the Village presentation. I'm most certainly appreciative of the resiliency and fortitude of the resident and business communities in bouncing back from the lingering effects of the COVID campaign. To begin, I'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge my colleagues on the Village Board and all of our Village employees who work hard to ensure Lisle is a welcoming, community-oriented village where residents and businesses thrive. Together, we will continue to plan for the future, invest in infrastructure, and strive for ongoing improvement. This past fall, the Village conducted its first community survey. The Village's 2022 to 2025 strategic plan contains outcome metrics for each of our four strategic performance areas to be followed in measuring progress towards achieving the Village's overall vision for the community, including resident perception of the community. At this time, I'd like to introduce Village Manager Ertmode to present information regarding the community survey. Welcome, Village Manager.
There you are. Good evening, everyone. As the mayor mentioned, my name is Eric Ertmode. It's my privilege to serve as Lisle Village Manager. This past fall, as the mayor mentioned, the village had partnered with Polco to administer the National Community Survey, which provides a standardized and comprehensive picture of livability and resident satisfaction pertaining to local government services. On the national benchmark side, pertain to local government services that are benchmarked against other similar sized communities throughout the country. A few highlights of the survey finding includes that Lisle residents enjoy an exceptional quality of life here in Lisle and describe the village as welcoming and inclusive. Most residents perceive the village as a safe place to live. Residents value Lisle's economy and emphasize its importance. And residents appreciate Lisle's natural environment and recreational opportunities. Aspects of development, growth, and transportation in the village are lauded by residents and are strengths of the community. On the national benchmark comparisons, Lisle scored higher than the average in 45 areas, similar to 103 areas, and below average in just two of areas related to shopping and some downtown development. The results of the survey will be used by the Village Board and staff in making decisions and determining the best use of village resources based on resident priorities. At this time, I'd like to hand the presentation back over to the mayor. Thank you.
Thank you, Village Manager Ertmode. 2023 marked an exciting year for events in the village. Events that supported community building, drew visitors to Lisle, and furthered intergovernmental cooperation. The French Market had another successful season, which ran through mid-October, providing market goers an opportunity to purchase unique, locally sourced items from the assortment of vendors at the market. Partnering with the Ross Bishop VFW and the Lisle Woodridge Fire Protection District, the village observed Memorial Day with a community parade through downtown Lisle and a remembrance ceremony at the Lisle Veterans Memorial. Similarly, the village and Lisle Park District hosted an Independence Day concert event complete with fireworks, live concerts, food and drink vendors, and a parade. The Police Department's National Night Out and Public Works Touch a Truck event was a hit this year, attracting a large crowd of families and children. National Night Out is a nationally celebrated community building campaign promoting police community partnerships. Attendees were able to see village vehicles and equipment up close and learn about village operations from our talented staff team. And in December, we were able to celebrate the holiday season with Lights of Lisle, featuring streets and sidewalks adorned with over 1,000 luminaria, complete with food and drink vendors, festive music, shopping specials from local retailers, ice carvings, welcoming Santa to town with a Santa parade, personal visits with Santa at the Depot Museum, and a tree lighting ceremony to start an evening of holiday celebration. Even a surprise appearance from the Grinch failed to steal the festive mood. It was certainly a pleasure to share the holiday joy with friends, neighbors, new residents, and visitors to the Lisle community. As a reminder, Main Street trees will remain illuminated longer this year to help brighten the shorter winter days and carry the cheer through Valentine's Day. This past August, with support from the DuPage Sports Commission, Benedictine University hosted the USA Track and Field National Masters Throws Championships, featuring athletes competing in shot put, discus, hammer throw, javelin, and more. Also this past summer, the Village of Lisle was one of 29 DuPage communities that participated in the Andy Warhol exhibition promotion through a partnership with the McKinnich Arts Center at the College of DuPage. The exhibition drew over 32,000 visitors to the region from 50 states and 28 countries. The Lisle community added its own artistic touch by participating in the Pop Art Challenge, displaying Warhol-themed light pole banners in the downtown and decorating refuse and recycling receptacles with Warhol's iconic Campbell's Soup can-style wraps. As an added feature, the Lisle Area Chamber organized and installed colorful pop art style yarn wraps on trees throughout downtown Lisle. I want to extend a big thank you to the Lisle Library District for their efforts in helping make Warhol a success in Lisle. In November, I proclaimed November 25th, 2023, the Saturday after Thanksgiving as Small Business Saturday in the village and urged people to shop local, not only that day, but throughout the year. As I frequently share, shopping local helps keep sales tax dollars in Lisle and helps diversify the village's revenue sources. And the Lisle dining scene keeps growing. This past year, we welcomed several new businesses offering various cuisine and dining options. This includes some exciting new eateries such as La Michoacana, Shawarmati Restaurant, Kindred Gastropub, and Jimmy John's Sandwiches. The much anticipated Little Pops New York Pizza Trattoria joined the Lisle community, renovating the former Country House building at 2799 Maple Avenue with a fully redone interior and exterior facade improvements. It's a trip to New York right here in Lisle. Some other businesses that opened their doors in Lisle this past year included Dollar Tree, Multivac, Blossom Beauty Salon, Cylinders Incorporated, Caring Smile Dental, DeVry University, The Plug T-Shirt Store and Printing, Local Honey Trove, Ace Motorworks, DB Group Cross Country Mortgage, Jennifer Rizzo Design Company, Comfify, Karma and Love Corp, Vitality Health Center, Institute for Meditation and Inner Harmony, Papa John's Pizzeria, Cheap Cheap Liquor Incorporated, the Millennium Group Incorporated, Northwoods Humidor, and Gesecki and Deverent ePayments America Incorporated. And the most recent business to open, Crooked Arm Vinyl and Tap, located at College Square Shopping Center at 6450 College Road, featuring new and used records for sale, a tap room, and a bottle shop. Turning to financial matters, in 2023, the Village received the highly distinguished Triple Crown Award for Financial Reporting by the Government Finance Officers Association. GFOA's Triple Crown designation recognizes governments that have received GFOA's Certificate of Achievement for Excellence in Financial Reporting, a popular annual financial reporting award and distinguished budget presentation award for a given fiscal year. This makes Lisle one of just 331 government entities that received this award. This important undertaking required notable work by the Village's financial team and Village Manager's Office. The Village also published its fourth annual Budget in Brief that serves as a summarized version of the Village's annual budget, which includes a high-level overview of major revenues, expenditures, investments in capital infrastructure, supported services, and other important information. New this year, the Budget in Brief is presented in an online format through OpenGov cloud-based software. Newly launched in 2023, the Village's online checkbook provides the public on-demand access to detailed budget and financial information of the Village. The Village of Lisle continues to raise the bar when it comes to communicating local government spending and financial status in an accessible and transparent manner. As mayor, I remain committed to diversifying village revenue sources and decreasing the property tax burden on residents and commercial property owners. 2023 marks the seventh year in a row without an increase to property tax levy. Coupled with growing EAV, the result is another year of decrease in the village's property tax rate and real savings to home and business property owners. Lisle's equalized assessed value, or EAV, has grown to an estimated amount of $1,200,631,171, everyone is important, in 2023, a 2.12% increase over 2022. This increase is partially attributed to new construction estimated at $1.5 million. The village currently receives a nickel of every dollar paid in property taxes, or 5% of a resident's overall tax bill, with the remainder being paid to other taxing bodies such as schools, DuPage County, townships, park and library districts, and other service districts. Let's quickly recap new construction and building activity in Lisle. Over the course of last year, total building permits issued superseded the previous year high, with 1,494 permits having been issued. This increase in permit activity is supported by the village's citizen service portal that continues to help streamline online permit processing, making for more efficient and timely staff reviews and easier access for users to apply for and receive permits. A significant portion of the village's annual property tax levy is allocated to the police pension fund to meet funding requirements set by Illinois statute. In order to best meet our obligation to the dedicated police officers who serve our community, the village's funding policy target exceeds the standards set by the state of Illinois without the need for a steep tax increase. Sales tax revenue is a direct indicator of goods bought and sold in our local economy. In 2023, Lisle saw a 13.83% increase in sales tax revenue when comparing fiscal year 2022 to 2021. The average increase for Downers Grove, Glen Ellen, Naperville, Westmont, Wheaton, and Woodridge was a weighted total average of just 5.8%. As sales tax information for total calendar year 2023 is not completely available, this table includes a comparison of the first three quarters of 2022 and 2023. Lisle saw a 12.94% increase in sales tax revenue comparing the first three quarters of 23 to 22. The average for other communities was 3.17%. During the previous fiscal year, sales taxes became the village's top revenue source, overtaking the property tax levy for the first time since 1999. This past year, undoubtedly, inflation and the prospect of a slowing economy have been on all of our minds, households and businesses alike. While the village's budget has not been immune to inflation either, current consensus is that our financial position remains strong and stable, resisting any overspending and maintaining a better than fully funded general fund reserve, if and when a rainy day might arrive. Lisle continues to be a sought after location for business due to its lower than average tax rates and low utility costs, including water rates, compared to neighboring communities. Speaking of water, this fall, the Village Board approved a new 40-year agreement with the DuPage Water Commission to provide a Lake Michigan water supply to Lisle for decades to come. All told, these numbers tell the story that we can all agree with, that locating and investing in Lisle, either as a resident or as a business, is one of the best investments that can be made. In 2023, the Village Board made significant headway regarding several large development projects that are planned to begin this year. The Family Square redevelopment project, located at the southeast corner of Ogden Avenue and Main Street. This past September, the board approved a preliminary plat of subdivision, special use permits, and variances for the property. This will allow for construction of a mixed-use building that includes 198 residential dwellings, 6 live-work units, 22,887 square feet of commercial space, and a 482-space parking garage that includes 90 public parking spaces. The Village Board also approved ordinances authorizing the development of a new subdivision, Estates at River's Edge, located at 1195 Summerhill Drive, 1/2 mile from Route 53. This redevelopment site is the site of the former Marriott Hickory Ridge Hotel. Initiated by Pulte Homes, this development will include construction of a 78-lot residential subdivision improved with 74 single-family homes. The village's portion of the development is part of a larger subdivision shared with the Village of Woodridge. Site clearing permits have just been applied for this development, foreshadowing a groundbreaking in the very near future. Good process and planning leads to great outcomes. The village nears the finish line of its update to Lisle's comprehensive land use plan. The village's comprehensive land use plan serves as a policy guide for future land use and development. Since the 2004 plan was adopted, the village is engaged in a number of planning efforts that provide focused development goals and strategies for specific areas, as well as a broad update to the village's zoning code. There's much to look forward to in the year ahead as Lisle remains a popular destination for regional events. Excitement is building in anticipation of the arrival of February as Lisle enthusiastically awaits to host the highly anticipated DuPage Sports Commission's Midwest Esports Invitational, to be held at the Hyatt Regency and Scrims Esport Gaming Center. This regional event features two full action-packed days of college esports games battling head-to-head in three different video games with a $10,000 prize pool at stake. A market report conducted in 2022 showed that video games overtook the market value of both digital music and box office combined. The Midwest Esports Invitational was created with the intention to serve and grow the esports ecosystem, bringing together some of the best collegiate athletes, up-and-coming high school gamers, fans, and the community through a unique atmosphere of competition and connection. The village continues to work with our regional economic development partners, the DuPage Convention and Visitors Bureau, and Choose DuPage, on promoting Lisle as a popular destination for visitors and businesses alike. Of the 9 workplaces recognized by Choose DuPage as the smartest, sleekest, and healthiest workplaces in 2023, 4 were in Lisle. Congratulations to Leco Steel, Westside Tractor Sales, Greenleaf Foods, and RE Development Solutions at 2200 Cabot Drive. Related, if you or your company know of a company looking for space to better meet business and employee needs, be sure to contact the village's economic development manager, George Kafka, today. The village is ready and able to assist with a site selection process. It's no secret the hospitality industry, specifically full-service hotels, like the one this presentation was presented in originally, were hardest hit by the pandemic campaign, with forced closures and restricted travel resulting in low room tax revenues coming out of 2020. I'm pleased to report that all of Lisle's hotels continue to remain open as business picks back up, resulting in better than budgeted Village's hotel motel tax revenue figures. Looking ahead, businesses continue to see opportunity in locating and doing business in Lisle. Rush University Medical Center continues their plans for opening a 55,000 square foot cancer treatment center at 2455 Corporate West Drive, part of the I-88 Warrenville Road corporate corridor. The new site's services will include infusion therapy, radiation therapy, supportive oncology, lab services, a pharmacy, and urgent cancer care. We will also welcome two new additions to the R. Salerno Restaurant Group's business portfolio at the southwest corner of Ogden Avenue and Main Street in downtown Lisle. This proposed business will convert the semi-vacant property into a breakfast, lunch, bar, restaurant, and deli sandwich retail food market shop. The new owner intends to completely remodel the property's interior and exterior components and plans on serving a breakfast and lunch menu that includes breakfast pizzas, healthy options, and staple traditional items. The proposed deli retail store will serve lunch and sell retail food items for purchase. Businesses continue to see the value of locating in Lisle, with many exciting things coming, making Lisle the ideal place to choose to live, go to work, and enjoy. The village will continue to work diligently in meeting and exceeding expectations of residents, businesses, and others. We truly look forward to welcoming these businesses and others as we start 2024 off strong. This year, Lisle is proud to announce its first Restaurant Week, which will occur April 16th through 19th. This event will showcase a variety of restaurants throughout the village where diners can enjoy specials, discounts, and fixed-priced menu options. Get ready for a week of delicious food and exclusive dining experiences. Environmental sustainability remains a focal point in village initiatives. 2023 marked the 31st year the village has been awarded the Distinguished Tree City USA Award by the Arbor Day Foundation for its commitment to effective urban forest management. This milestone was celebrated by the planting of a ceremonial persimmon tree at Prairie Walk Pond and handing out saplings to residents. The 2023 Sustainable Saturday Recycling Event was another success this year, with 11 recycling vendors serving 722 vehicles that dropped off items over a 3-hour time period. This could not have been accomplished without the assistance of partner agencies and event volunteers. The 2024 event is once again planned for this March at Benedictine University. Long-term planning for vital village infrastructure remains top of mind. The village continues to responsibly plan for the future and growth, which includes generating the greatest value from tax revenue and making investments in the village's infrastructure. The village remains committed to communicating important information to its residents. At this time, I'd like to introduce Public Works Director Jason Elias to speak to us a little bit about Public Works projects. Thank you, Director.
Good evening, everyone. Details regarding ongoing and upcoming capital improvement and private development projects can be found online on a map developed by village staff to communicate project location, detail, status, images, and other important project information. The Lisle Levee Elevation Project along the east branch of the DuPage River, in partnership with the United States Army Corps of Engineers, remains in progress. This long-term project, which includes many steps along the way, leverages a federal cost-sharing agreement with the Army Corps. Through our partnership, the goal is to reestablish the levee system in a manner that will improve the functionality of the levee system that runs through the center of Lisle. The North Connector bike and hike path continues in its planning stages and awaits the reconstruction of DuPage County's Warrenville Road Bridge over the east branch of the DuPage River. This path will connect downtown Lisle to our neighbors at the north of us, including the Arboretum, Hidden Lake Forest Preserve, and the communities of Glen Ellen and Lombard, joining them to our community. Further developments will one day join us to Green Trails, Peach Creek, the Southern Regional Trail, and Seven Bridges in the communities of Naperville and Woodridge. This year, stormwater system improvements are planned, including projects on Scarlet Oak Lane, Village Center South, a 2024 floodplain management study, and the Old Tavern Road culvert rehabilitation. Many of these stormwater projects are being funded by the village's portion of funds received through the American Rescue Plan Act. The village also continues its floodplain property acquisition and demolition program aimed at acquiring and demolishing structures in the floodway and regulatory floodplain. In 2023, the village acquired 6 properties for demolition in the floodplain. Maintaining our roadways is a vital service that's important to the many individuals and businesses that count on them. In addition to important stormwater infrastructure improvements, many roadway system improvements are planned for 2024, including the annual road rehabilitation program, which resurfaces approximately 2 miles of village roads. This year, work will begin on the design of the Burlington Avenue reconstruction project, in which the village received $2.6 million in federal surface transportation program funds provided to the state of Illinois. In 2024, water and sewer system improvements are scheduled, including rehabilitation of our backup well number 3, Main Street sanitary sewer rehabilitation, a water system model project, and water meter AMI implementation, or automated meter infrastructure. At this time, I'd like to hand things back over to the mayor.
Thank you.
With long-term plans in effect, community leadership, and a dedicated, capable, and professional staff, many good things are in store for Lisle. I wish you all the best in the coming year and hope to share in more of the events that make our community the premier location in the region. At this time, if I may, I'd like to announce this year's Community Recognition Award winners. Among several submittals, I have chosen 2, one as citizens and one as a business enterprise. I'd like to first call up Vaibhavi and her son Sumail, who started the Buy Nothing community on Facebook. Come on around to this side here. Vaibhavi and her son Sumail, now a senior at Naperville North High School, started the Buy Nothing Lisle Community of Givers in 2020 on Facebook. They selflessly completed multiple training sessions and, after a slow start building the community, now deserve the recognition of creating a 2,000 plus group of generous community givers and grateful community of gift recipients. Now, this is all Lisle residents. It's limited to Lisle, 2,000 residents in Lisle, all non-financially trading, upcycling, and preventing things from going into a landfill.
Yes.
Thank you very much for all the work you've done that on that. In recognition is that plaque. Enjoy it, and thank you for all you do. If you'd like to share a few words with everybody about your efforts, you're welcome to.
Thank you, Mayor, for those insightful words. Again, without the help of Lisle and everyone sitting here today with us, we wouldn't be able to achieve what we have done. I know we as Lisle residents and citizens put a lot of emphasis on sustainability, and at Buy Nothing, I think we really do do just that with the sustainability and reuse. Thank you.
I just wanted to bring it up that when I initially wanted to get into a Buy Nothing group, I went into a neighboring cities group, and they basically said, oh, you're out of our boundary. We can't accept you. I was really sad because I had so many things in my house that I wanted to kind of get rid of, and I couldn't. So I told my son, you know what? I really like this project. It's a really good project that we should pursue. But I didn't think anything about it because there was a lot of training that we had to do. But he eventually kind of told me, hey, this is something you really want. We should go ahead and do it. And he sat with me for the training. He trained himself. He trained me. And like a few months later, we got approved by the project. The Facebook group got approved by the real project, and now we have 2,000 plus members who are giving everything from their abundance. And if somebody wants something, they can even go to the group and ask to keep or to borrow stuff. So I think it's really nice. And I really thank him for doing that.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And for tonight's second award, this I've chosen an organization that's been around since approximately the mid-80s. It's an organization that does a lot of great work, but very, very few people know about it. It's the Lisle Community Service Corporation. I'd like to invite their members up here that do all this giving out grants and awards to members of the Village of Lisle, to residents of the Village of Lisle and organizations in the Village of Lisle, in the amounts of $5,000 per grant. They are Ray Kipper as president, Tom Kamichek as vice president, Carlene Smith, isn't that here? Joan Costin is director, Debbie Brinehan is director, Kathleen Kelly, and Pat Kowetzel. Those two aren't here. But I want to recognize the organization. I want to draw the public's attention to it, because it's been a quite a long time, quite an achievement of what you've achieved with a financial endowment, and the good work that you continue to do. And I'll give you an opportunity to describe the work that you do.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Lisle Community Service Corporation gives out grants twice a year, up to $5,000 each. And they're given to not-for-profit organizations who work within Lisle. And they can be outside of Lisle, but they have to some way affect the people of Lisle and help the people of Lisle. We also give out 8 $1,000 scholarships to graduating seniors in schools that have Lisle students there.
Thank you very much. And with that, I would like to present the organization with this plaque. Thank you for all you do.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Absolutely. Okay. Thank you to the recipients this year. Thank you to everybody. Thank you for everybody that contributes to the community. And thank you all for being here tonight for this presentation. Thank you. Have a good evening.